Jono Fisher this morning from Cauldron Energy. Jono, good morning. Good to see you.
G'day, Andrew. Thanks for having me.
We've been undertaking a bit of a strategy refresh, if you like, at Cauldron. Give us a snapshot of where the business is at currently.
Yeah, thanks. Look, we're about 6 months into a renewal. That's both a corporate management renewal and also a strategy renewal. I started about 6 months ago, and we've had a new chairman, Ian Mulholland, start as well. Ian's extremely well-respected in the exploration space. And over that 6 months period, we've refined the company's strategy, focused on exploring the energy transition, which provides us the opportunity to support our cornerstone asset, which is the Yanrey Uranium Project in WA, but also look a little broader.
Tell us a little bit more about the Yanrey Project and what stage it's at.
Yeah, so look, Yanrey is, in my view, one of the most attractive uranium assets in WA. It's world scale, so it's big. It's leachable. Now, that means it's capable to be developed through an in-situ leach process. You don't have to physically move the dirt. That allows a CapEx and OpEx attractive development. And there's been a lot of work done on it, such that when the uranium policy in WA changes, you know, we can be one of the first cabs off the rank.
Are we expecting a change in stance on uranium mining?
Yeah, look, there's been a little bit of chatter about this, and the events with Mr. McGowan in the last couple of weeks have led to some scuttlebutt. Not that the policy will change overnight, but perhaps a change in government is closer in WA than it was otherwise thought to be. And you know, the trend globally with nuclear and a renaissance happening, it will come home to roost in Australia. We've seen that starting with AUKUS, and you know, large scale reactors are coming to Australia. It won't be long before there's a necessity for us to allow uranium mining back in WA.
Well, look, just on that, you mentioned the strength in the uranium price. Tell us a little bit more about what's driving the sentiment here.
Yeah, so look, uranium has been in the doldrums for 10 plus years, and now you've seen a very strong price performance in the last 6 months. Look, globally, and look, my background is in nuclear industry in Europe and UK. Look, there was always a concern that end of life considerations around nuclear waste and safety sort of trumped the benefit of low cost, low carbon megawatt hours. But now, with concern on the energy transition and decarbonisation, you know, globally people are realising that nuclear is a really important part of the energy transition and providing those zero carbon baseload megawatt hours, and that is driving a nuclear renaissance globally. You're starting to see that come through in thinking in Australia, although we're probably a bit behind.
Well, apart from the initial CapEx, nuclear, of course, is relatively cheap and reliable.
Yeah, so from an OPEX perspective, relatively cheap. Once it's on, subject to, you know, scheduled maintenance, but really does provide the large scale opportunity to swap out coal, which is crucial for decarbonisation.
Well, Jono, just away from uranium, you've also got the Melrose project. Tell us a bit more about this.
Yeah, look, we picked this up a few weeks ago. We're very excited about it, and we've done it in a manner which really, the way we picked it up was cheap. You know, we've been concerned about shareholder dilution. It's a nickel PGEs kind of play, you know, in and around the Julimar area, near Dalwallinu and WA. We've got some great neighbours in terms of Chalice, and actually Nicolex just to the east of us. And we benefit from some historic drilling results that were actually done by Independence Group in around 2006. So, you know, we've picked up an asset. We've got four walk-up drill targets already with good grades of nickel, actually better grades than Chalice in many areas. And, you know, it's a really good low-cost entry. And, you know, you wouldn't believe it for the market cap we currently have.
Are you looking at further project acquisitions?
Yeah, and this is, we're rounding out our portfolio, and I was clear in my last presentation that you can probably expect us to pick up another asset in due course, and it would be of a similar style, low-cost entry into an attractive sector. That's driven by, you know, our chairman, Ian Mulholland, extremely well-respected geologist, our exploration manager, Angelo, who started with us a few months ago, and then the corporate team, which is myself and our executive director, Mike Fry, have got, you know, I think between us, we've just got too many years doing this kind of thing, and world-class team to be able to assess and pick up some really good assets.
Well, Jono, you mentioned before about the market cap. What would be your message this morning to investors taking a look at Cauldron Energy?
Well, look, you know, prior to the change in uranium policy in WA in 2017, our share price was about 30 cents. It's now a cent or under. And, you know, it's the company's been in the doldrums and in the wilderness, I guess, for a few years. We're now emerging from that. And you can just see that the upside is present there when the winds start to change in uranium in WA. And secondly, when the market starts to see the quality of the assets that we're able to pick up and progress. You know, there's a lot of good blue sky there. And I just encourage our shareholders, we have 1,800 of them. They've been a little bit disengaged in recent years, but, you know, we're back, rebranded, refreshed. Pay attention, and to all those new investors out there, worth putting us on your watch list.
Good to speak, Jono. Thanks for your time.
Cheers, mate. Bye.